recognize water as a human right. We'll go over first order. Now, water as a human right. The United Nations has already passed a resolution recognizing the human right to water and sanitation. It's entrenched in international law. It's binding. It's easy for the three simply add a name to it. Promoting publicly financed, owned, and operated water and wastewater services. Difficult of the three, but worth the last number of years in Innisfil. The opening of the service water treatment plant and improvements to municipal water services has turned this from arduous to easy, or done the heavy lifting. The third and possibly most contentious is the banning of the sale of bottled water at public facilities and at municipal events.
This is not the only one, there are seven more. This bowl represents the amount of oil required to make this one bottle. Curving the sale of water bottles, as you can see, this could greatly reduce the need for millions of barrels of oil, drilling and pipelines, and lower oil and gas prices. Most of the water sold by water companies is tap water. Just comes out of the tap. It is sold at a markup. Huge.
Ontario was discouraged that we drink bottled water. We have refillable bottles that we could use, and it seems to be a concern going across Canada and conservation authorities.
I have spent the last 5 years working with the Clean Water Act, so I'm converted, obviously. Certainly, what we have to do is convince our residents to have confidence in drinking tap water, and certainly, you know, since Robyn, that took a plunge. We even just recently were at the Celebrate Lakes and Cove Festival, and our water department was there, and residents in the town were coming out saying, "Well, I heard that our water's not safe to drink."
Good luck. Myself, accepted by the reason that delegation is fancy and trivial at the Council of Canadian Central Region Chapter regarding the Blue Box Community Project. Thank you, Mayor.
Thanks. I think you may be concerned with the word box. With the removal of that word, your motion is friendly. Council, all in favor? That's carried. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Inspired and inspiring youth from Kingston. I'll let her get into her story. Please join me in welcoming youth water activist Robyn Hamlyn.
Start off by thanking Mira for the wonderful speech, and I want to thank everyone here for having me here today. You have no idea how happy I am coming here to talk to all of you. Now, my name is Robyn Hamlyn. I am 13 years old, and I'm a grade 8 student from Kingston. I'm here today to share my story and to talk about the world's water problem. Now, my story begins in June of 2011, where my teacher showed our class a video called Blue Gold, World Water Wars, a documentary that Sam Botso directed in 2008. This is a movie that hits you hard. It tells us how our water is being destroyed by mankind. It talks about how we are polluting, pumping, and wasting our limited supply of water. It talks about how we are polluting, pumping, and wasting our limited supply of water. This movie shows you how people are having to fight for such a simple right that is our water. People are dying because they don't have access to clean, fresh water. And it tells you that soon enough, we too will be those people. And this movie hit me hard. But instead of walking out of my classroom complaining about how long and depressing the movie was, I had walked out of that classroom determined to do something about it. Now, I never planned on doing something huge, and at that moment, I just wanted to do anything that could help this crisis. And so when I got home at the end of the day, I told my mom how I felt, and I told her that we can't just wait around for somebody to do something, and I wanted to do something now. And she told me if I wanted to, I could write a letter to our mayor telling him my concerns. I did. I sent my letter to Mayor Mark Gerritsen, and my mom told me not to expect a reply because the mayor is a very busy man. In August, when we came back from a trip, there was a message on our answering machine from the mayor's secretary saying that the mayor had received my letter and would love to meet with me to discuss my concerns.
There you go, wow.
So obviously this shocked both my parents, including my mom, and it sent my spirits over the moon. I was so happy that I would have a chance to make a difference. One of my fears, though, was the mayor sending me home with a couple of tips on how to conserve water, and him assuring me that Kingston's a very green city and that I shouldn't be worried. I thought to myself that I got an appointment with the mayor, and I wouldn't let it be a waste of time. So my mom and I, we did a big bit of digging, and we ended up contacting the director of the movie, Sam Botso. We told him that we had this one shot with my mayor, and was there anything specific to Kingston that I could ask him to do. Sam was very proud that I had taken this upon myself, and he said he could connect me with Maude Barlow, who would be able to help me. I did. I got connected with Maude, and she told me that if I asked my mayor to make Kingston a blue community, it would be taking a positive step in the right direction. I was told that Kingston had already banned the sale of bottled water in public facilities and at municipal events, and that their water and wastewater services were already publicly owned. So I walked into the mayor's office feeling extremely nervous, but ready for anything. I told him my concerns and then asked him if we could make Kingston a blue community. He then invited me to come speak to City Council. And you can imagine how I felt when I walked out of his office, beaming and bursting with excitement, almost ready to explode. So it was on September 20th that I presented to Kingston City Council, and it was on September 20th that Kingston became a blue community that night.
Mm-hmm. Wowee.
So in my letter to Mayor Mark Gerritsen, I said I wanted to take this as far as possible, and I plan to keep that promise. I sent a mass mailing of about 50 letters to mayors across Ontario, telling them what I had accomplished and if I could come and speak to them to try and make their communities blue communities. I was overwhelmed with the responses I got. Emails and letters came in almost every day. The mayor of Oshawa called me on Saturday morning, when I was still in my pajamas, to invite me to meet with him. A representative from the town of Ajax called me to tell me that they actually took my letter, brought it to council without me knowing, and got all three resolutions passed on November 28th. So wow. They are now a blue community.
Wow.
So far, I've made trips in December, February, and over my March break. I've met with mayors, deputy mayors, and councilors in 14 different communities. Wow. And made three presentations to councils. The last and biggest trip was over March break, where we went as far west as Chatham and as far north as Owen Sound. On March 13th, I presented to Norfolk City Council. They passed the human rights resolution without any difficulty. They agreed to phase out the sale of bottled water in public facilities and at municipal events, with some exceptions. Unfortunately, their wastewater facilities are privately owned. Even though they own the building, it is privately run, and they don't have enough money to change this. I'm still happy with the results, but I do want to try and pass that last resolution. So I am happy to say that almost all of my meetings have been very positive and has resulted in invitations back to speak to their councils. With every meeting and every email, I'm learning more and more. I have met with people that support me and think the same way as I do. And I have met some people that give me all sorts of excuses why this can't be done. Some communities find one resolution more difficult to pass than the other. Some communities, like the town of Ajax, pass all resolutions without any difficulties. These tend to be my favorite kind of cities.
And ours.
So my biggest struggle is trying to make people understand how bad our situation is, and that we have to act now and instead of later. I get frustrated with people getting hung up on small details, and when they should be looking at the bigger, more scarier picture. Just some of the scary facts that I've shared in my meetings are that our Earth holds 97% salt water and 3% fresh water. Almost all of that 3% is already polluted. Because Canada is a water-rich country, we tend to take our water for granted, and we use up water faster than it can be replenished through natural systems. Canada, Russia, and Brazil are the water-rich countries of the world. As fresh water starts to disappear or become polluted, the rest of the world will want water from these three places. America has severe water problems and has already planned canals able to move Canadian water into America. I know that the Great Lakes are a big target because Canada and America share them. What is really scary, though, is that they are saying this will probably happen within 10 to 20 years from now, when I'm a young adult. Governments are selling water cheaply to big bottled water companies. These companies are then selling our water for huge profits. To manufacture 1 liter of bottled water, over 6 liters of water is required. Bottled water companies are saying that their water is safer, but this isn't completely true. Bottled water, because it is defined as a food under federal regulations, is under the authority of the Food and Drug Administration, while the Environmental Protection Agency, under much stricter standards, regulates tap water. Thus, bottled water, depending upon the brand, may actually be less clean and safe than tap water.
There you go.
Bottled water companies say that they are providing us a healthier alternative, but we have to open our eyes and look at the costs. Overpumping of our precious water, destruction of our watersheds, and all the greenhouse gases they've produced in trying to give us a healthier alternative, which we can easily get from the tap. Now, these facts do scare me, but I do have hope. There are many problems in the world that man has created, but that doesn't mean that man cannot fix them. My mom has a quote on her fridge that says the following: "I'm only one, but I am one. I cannot do everything, but I can do something. What I can do, I ought to do, and by the grace of God, I will do." I believe in I believe in the power of one, and I believe that when you have a passion for something, you can do almost anything. I also believe, even though our reality looks really bad right now, if we work together, one community at a time, we can save our planet's life source. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Not only for being here today, but for all the work that you're doing on behalf of all of us. Thank you so much.